Welcome. My name's Illmatic, and you're watching Victoria 2, A House Divided by Paradox. Makers of many fine titles, such as Europa Universalis 3 and Hearts of Iron, and this is another grand strategy world map. As it was in 1836, so you'll notice some things which are different from the present day world, such as look at the prevalence of Austria, for instance, and of course you got Prussia, the precursor to Germany, which may be formed in this game, depending on how well they do. We'll see. Over here in the United States, you have Washington and Oregon, which have yet to be colonized, much of Canada still unexplored. Mexico owns California and much of the Midwest. They will soon go to war with the United States over Texas, which is, of course, an independent state. Spain owns Cuba. Much of South America has already achieved independence by this time, so nothing to colonize there. But over here in Africa, it is pretty much up for grabs. I mean, other than a few possessions, Britain has key possessions all over the map. Let's be honest, they are the preeminent world superpower. But, you know, there's things we can do to try to get around that. Yeah, other than, you know, Ivory Coast, Gold Coast, the Cape, there's a lot to be had here in Africa. So we'll see about that. Over here in the Far East, not a lot going on, to be honest. Japan is what's known in the game as an uncivilized nation. Now, I won't begin too much at the start right now getting bogged down explaining game mechanics. I'm going to assume that at least some of you understand the game of Victoria 2 and are familiar with it. Hence, that's why you clicked on this game to watch it. But we will be explaining it as we go along for those of you that aren't so familiar, so fret not. Anyhow, though, Japan is uncivilized. In time, they can become quite powerful. And they are a fun nation to play through as well. But we shall see how they do. Well, what I love about this game is even though it sets you up in a certain historically accurate construct, let's say, you know, the world map in 1836, and it's got certain predispositions where certain nations historically don't like each other or do like each other, and, you know, it kind of sets you out on that start, but it can change entirely. I mean, it's interesting to see, you know, which nations come out on top from one game to the next. But China also very weak in this game. First off, they're fragmented. Even though it shows up as a union on the map, they are fragmented into different sects. Plus, they are also uncivilized, so a bit of a pushover. They're mainly just something for people to compete over the great powers later in the game to see who can sphere China, as it were, put them in their sphere of influence. Sphere. Anyhow, we will be playing through as Belgium, the lowland country of Belgium, who is, despite their size, one of the most industrialized nations in the world. They're actually fourth in the world in industry, and that is just behind the United States, France, and the UK in that order. So some pretty big, powerful nations, three of the biggest in the game, most powerful in the game. And this little tiny country right here is just behind them. Belgium in the game has recently acquired their independence from the Netherlands, but the Netherlands is not super cool about that. They are pretty peeved, to be honest with you. And they still consider Belgium their shit, so they're going to try to take it back at one point or another, and we will be getting in a scrap, that is for sure. Some of my short to near-term goals are going to be to perhaps take a province from the Netherlands, Gelderland. I'm going to try for that. That's this, like, right there. Of course, you didn't have Friesland and Holland proper, whereas Belgium is a collection of Vlaanderen and Wallonie. But, yeah, my main goal there in the near future is going to be trying to take Dutch Java, which is pretty much the crown jewel of the Dutch Empire. It is a colony they established early on, and it has grown quite profitable over the years. So that'll definitely be a point of interest for us. But anyhow, let's go on and dive into it now in 1836 as Belgium. Now, as you start the game, Belgium is what's considered a secondary world power, and they are under the sphere of influence of the UK, which means if the Netherlands tries to attack us currently, UK will come to our defense. So I doubt that the Netherlands will do that until we're able to unsphere ourselves from the UK, which we can achieve if we get this world ranking score up to 8th, up from 11th that it is currently, which is harder than it seems, because there's some, you know, it isn't like there's just pushovers in front of us. Once you get this high in the rankings, you know, everybody's pretty good, and we're small, so that's something big to try to overcome. But let's see here. I would like to form an alliance with Prussia. That would be awesome. So let's see about that, because Prussia does have a lot of frontage on the border of the Netherlands, and they can kind of stream their troops in and provide some much needed support to our 39, looks like, or so soldiers. Yeah, 27 and 12. Luxembourg is a satellite of the Netherlands, so, you know, indirectly controlled, and they will be going to war with us as well if and when this war takes off. So we'll try to get Luxembourg, as I said, Gelderland, and Java. So anyhow, first things first, we need to set some technology. So we're going to try to improve our industry a bit. We're already a pretty big coal producing province, or nation, I should say. But we're going to try to expand that even further if we can. You'll notice we got a couple there which produce coal, and a couple that do iron. So and there's another coal one. Yeah, so we are prime for steel production, to be honest with you. We really are. And let's check that out. I'm not sure if we already have a steel factory in place to begin the game as one of our startup industries. We do, so that's nice. No unemployed workers, no unemployed clerks. Clerks improve the efficiency of the factories in which they work. And of course you need craftsmen to actually fill the factory up and make goods. So you can see that most of our factories are pretty well unstaffed. Out of the five little icons which can be full, most of these only have one, with this particular one here in Vlaanderen at two, and Wallonie has just over one, about one and a half there. Got a project going on. They're building a railroad in Vlaanderen, and it looks good. I mean, I could expand these factories, but there's really no need at the moment, being as that they are nowhere near full. They're all making a profit, so that's good. That's good news indeed. Now, you can subsidize these factories if they start to dip into the red and it's a product that you really need. You notice that perhaps another more important industry relies upon, or that your troops need to supply. But the problem with that is, of course, you do incur a financial penalty to do so, to be all socialist-like. Let's take a look at our taxes. This is weird. I don't have any kind. Normally, you've got a bit of a restriction on how far you can set the slider one way or the other, depending on your form of government, but apparently I can do whatever I want. I love how deep this game is. Not only the industry with what you're producing, different industries interconnected and down to your ability to produce units and ships and your supply, you also have all the population types, and it's not just a simple, are people happy? There's different types of people, and beyond that, different classes, and you can set independent tax brackets for all of them, try to encourage new forms. I mean, you can't just automatically, if you need this one type of person, it's not like you can just build them. I mean, you can make policy changes, which might encourage people through incentives to take up that profession, much like in real life, and you know, the way that real government works. So, very interesting. If not a bit overwhelming at times. I mean, look at all this just information. You see what people's ideologies are, what they're happy about, what issues they care about. Are they meeting their, you know, are they getting their needs? Are they pissed off? Are they ripe for rebellion? What's his consciousness? I mean, are these people getting more liberal, embracing socialistic ideas? I mean, it's all things you got to pay attention to. And so much information. I mean, if you're a stat geek like me, it's easy just to get lost in this game for hours and hours. So anyhow, we're gonna try to shake out of that real quick. What government do I have anyway? His Majesty's government. So apparently I can pick my party. This party doesn't have any limits on what I set my taxes at. Now I could go to the Liberal Party, and that's where I'm going to have free trade and all capitalists, so I won't be able to build factories. Not sure I want to jump into that just yet. And we also have the Nationalist Party, which has state capitalism as an option, which isn't too bad, because you can still build factories, but so can the capitalist. Same thing with interventionism, which I have right now. Anti-military. I don't like the sound of anti-military. I think I might want to go jingoist, to be honest with you. Yeah, this is all pretty well the same. Exception of state capitalism. Now, this will hurt my output, and it's going to make it more expensive to start one up. But other than that, it's pretty good just because of the jingoism. So I think I'm going to go with that. Switch to that right now. All right, there we go. We are a different form of government. Over here, you can see your social reforms and political reforms that you can enact. We do have... I'm playing on a slightly a modded version of the game, so there are a couple of liberal reforms already in place here. You can see. It doesn't sound like a whole lot. Trinket subsidies, a trinket minimum wage. But for the time, 1836, that's actually pretty progressive, so... we got some national decisions we can look at. Nothing we can enact right now, but something that can happen in the future. All right, we'll worry about that when we get to it. And that looks good. Okay. You know what? I could really use another alliance. Let me see. How you doing, France? No, you don't like me. Well, that's kind of rude. Is there anybody else that I could get a lovely alliance with? What about you, Austria? Maybe? Maybe. Okay. You know what? I can live with a maybe. Can live with it. Alright. I think we're pretty well good to go here. So I'm gonna go in and unpause it, and hopefully, we will get our alliances accepted. At least one of them, particularly from Prussia. Oh, we got both of them. That is beautiful. So beautiful that we got both of those alliances. I habitually save. It's just a habit I've got. I'm weird like that. Anyhow, yeah, it's pretty much going to be sitting around for a while and waiting for something to happen. Now, what I can try to do... And actually, I may do this, is go ahead and try to manufacture a justification for war. Of course, in this game, like many of Paradox games, you can't simply go to war with any nation you want. You have to, in essence, have a reason to some degree. Casus belli, justified war. Explain it to your people one way or the other. Let's see what's going on here real quick. Switzerland looks like they want an alliance. Sounds good to me, buddy. Sounds good. Let's go back into it. Yeah, let's try to justify a war against these guys. I don't feel like waiting around, because there's no telling how long it's going to take me to get out of the UK sphere, and if Netherlands doesn't attack me that entire time, well, that'll be quite boring. So I want a place in the sun. I really do. Though that will be hard. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it anyway. Netherlands ranked 9th in the world, higher than me. They have the 11th ranked military. What is my military rank? 52nd? Oh, man. 52nd in the world, that's pretty bad. Am I reading that right? Let's take a look. Yeah, look how far down we are. I didn't know if that 3 meant we were ranked 3rd, or we only have like 3 points worth of military score for a rank of 52nd in the world. That's pretty flipping bad. Whereas Netherlands is up here near the top, as you can see. China, a ton of soldiers. I mean, they're all low tech and will eventually end up getting stomped as the other nations progress right by them. But right now, I mean, just so many of the troops that they do have that large war score, as you can see. Industrial score, we are doing much better there. Score of 7 for a rank of 4. That's tied with Prussia. We need to try to pick that up. Prestige, that's kind of, you know, it's kind of like a score, an arcade-y type of score. Another way to factor into the rankings, and there's certain decisions and events and paths of action that you can take which will affect that prestige score, which can incur certain benefits as you move up the rankings. Kind of your international world status, as it were. But anyhow, I need to move this along, or this is going to take forever. So, let's see here. Wow, look at that navy that the UK has, 114 ships, whereas we have 3. Like, we might be able to go this whole game and never get that many ships. I'm not sure. Game options, audio. Let's turn these effects down a bit, shall we? That might be too much. That might be too much. How about that? That might be better. You guys just let me know if the levels aren't to your liking. I can always fiddle with that at another time. Oh, forgot about this. I have national foci where I can set certain focuses in my nation. Now, I'm curious of... Well, first off, the taxes are way too high on the middle class. Well, it's mainly artisans, though. And artisans tend to die out as they are. You know, an artisan is going to be like your shoemaker, your independent trade man, as it were, merchant man, who, you know, has learned a certain trade, and perhaps it's been passed down either from his father or family member or through a trade guild, a union, you know. Vestiges of the Middle Ages, they are replaced by the common laborer, the common craftsman, who works in factories as the game progresses, and it's actually more efficient to have factories producing those goods instead of getting them from independent artisans, as they're called, because their production is much more limited and more expensive, so... Anyhow, yeah, we need to, I think I do still need to, how much money am I making? Oh, I'm running at a deficit. No, I can't really change this then, unfortunately. I do want to know how many aristocrats and capitalists I have in my country, because I'm thinking I may want to encourage capitalists with, one of my, or both of my focuses, perhaps. 350 capitalists, and wow, a lot of aristocrats. Don't need any aristocrats for sure, but perhaps some capitalists would be in order, if not craftsmen. I mean, if I can encourage some more craftsmen, perhaps my factories can fill up faster. So let's do that. Encourage some craftsmen down here. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah. Because, I mean, if I encourage capitalists, sure, they can build new factories, but it won't do me a lick of good if I don't have anybody to actually work in those factories. So. France is trying to get a war against the Netherlands. Place in the sun. Just same kind of war I'm trying to get. That's where they can take a colony. And they better not be going for Java, because that is mine. I've already placed dibs on that in my mind. I don't know if you guys are like me, where at least to a certain degree you kind of role play your games. For instance, even going back to games of Civilization, I would I'd be expanding and I'd see a little patch of land over on a part of a map that I haven't built the settler yet to go over there or anything, but another nation, you know, jumps in there and tries to take what you in your mind knew was gonna be yours. Well, you know, you may not have had a quarrel with them before, and they were completely justified in the laws of the game in doing so. But in your mind, you had already claimed it, so therefore there would be war and consequences to pay. I know that's the case with me, at least. Get into seemingly unprovoked confrontations like that all the time. So, in fact, yeah, I even get offended. I'm like, how dare they? Now, they would know better. When in fact it's just the AI, you know, doing calculations, trying to see what would be the best path of expansion. So you can't really blame them. But I turn it into an insult. Let's see here. I'd really love to long term take over the entire Netherlands. So you've got a unified Lowlands down here. And that'd be a decent little size to begin with. And we may stop there in terms of continental affairs, and then focus our attention internationally. Perhaps expand here in Indonesia. Making headway into India is going to be tough, because that'll involve a direct conflict with the UK, which I would like to avoid if possible. Africa is always a prime candidate. You know, we could always try to pick on one of these South American nations, but we'll burn that bridge when we get there. One thing I would like to do is prevent the formation of Germany by Prussia, and they will do that if they get all these little independent German states in their sphere of influence. So I need to try to get these nations before they have a chance to. One prime one will be Hanover. I don't know, can you imagine if I had Hanover in addition to the Netherlands? Wow, that would be something. All right, Oldenburg is already in the sphere of Prussia, as is Bremen. What about Denmark? Denmark's at war with Prussia, actually, okay. And yeah, Prussia's probably gonna try to take Holstein. So they have a little passage up here. They can build a canal, I do believe. Mecklenburg is in their sphere as well. Is anybody not in their sphere? Bavaria's in Austria's sphere. Which they need Bavaria to form Germany proper. But they can still, even without that, form what's called the NGF, North German Federation. And that's quite formidable in its own right. So yeah, man, they've got all this shit sphered. Damn. I forgot they were this close to forming it, to be honest with you. I think my only hope, and I'm loath to do it, but my only hope will be to be Hanover. Now, currently you can't do much with them because they are in the UK's, not only sphere of influence, but they are a satellite of the UK, and they will soon no longer be so. As Queen Victoria ascends to the throne, Hanover doesn't believe in lady queens, lady rulers in general, so lady queens. It's all man queens over in Hanover. They're very progressive, actually. No, they don't believe in the sovereignty of a female as the supreme ruler. So they will leave their union with England over that. We'll see how that works out for them. They get gobbled up by Prussia. Or me, if I can help it. Or me. And if I gobble them up, well, that would be good. Very good indeed. So I need to wait until that event fires. Let me go over to my stuff here. Yeah, I can go ahead and start. No, I'm not a great power. Damn, I can't influence anything yet. I gotta get to 8th place. I really do. So, let's keep going here. And once again, I apologize, guys, for taking so long, but I can't help myself. There's just so much to do in this game. And, you know, I'm just gonna take my time and have fun. And you guys are welcome to hit the watch later button and pop in and out and, you know, progress along with this at your own pace. You may have noticed that the music in the background is different from the default Victoria 2 soundtrack. I changed it because it's a bit intense for my taste. A little bit, you know, the trumpets and the bump, 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 bump. It gets a little wearing. So again, in the spirit of a relaxed, chill session, I have changed the music out. So something a little more pleasant. Now you can, when you're trying to justify your wars to get a casus belli against nations, you can get detected, you know, you can get found out for what you're doing, and you will incur what's called infamy for doing that. And infamy is a certain score that you get for it. So it's the best way I can explain infamy is think of Germany before World War II, you know, with Hitler gobbling up certain nations in Europe. And if that was modeled in the game, what would have happened is he would have got a little bit of infamy for these attacks and these unprovoked attacks on certain parts of Europe until finally his infamy score would have been too high, and that's when the nations banded together to try to contain. Yeah, and they've had these before throughout history, what they call wars of containment. And that's where certain nations would band together in an alliance to try to keep one of their rivals from getting too large. That was a big part of politics in the 1700s and 1800s, actually, before World War II ever came about. So anyhow, let's need to keep an eye on that, on our infamy score, because if it gets too high and these nations start allying against us, that is going to be bad. Let's see here. As our diplomatic points, we need that to perform, you know, certain diplomatic actions. And oh no, our military power dropped. How do I only have 1 point? How did I lose military power? I haven't changed anything. Huh? I'm trying to build us. Oh my God! What happened to my military? We have fielded 13 out of 8. Why should Netherlands get all the prime colonial land? It's downright unfair, and that's what it is. They probably aren't even properly exploit educating the native population. Something must be done. We deserve our place in the sun. I agree with you. So that increased our casus belli generation speed. So right now we're trying to generate a casus belli to go to war on the Netherlands. And that should speed up a little bit. Our economy seems to be going well, at least. That's going kind of like gangbusters there. Let's check our military. Come on. I'm not sure why our amount of brigades that we can field dropped so suddenly. It couldn't possibly be to do with our change in government, would it? I mean, because switching jingoistics should have only helped matters, I would have thought. Well, you can spend more on the military when you're anti-military, oddly enough. So pro-military is nice. I kind of like that better, because you got the more military spending plus the faster reinforce speeds and organization speeds and such and such. But free trade's a killer. I don't really want free trade, so... Yeah, sure. Become more liberal. We have gained the casus belli to try to get Java, and that's really what we want. So, I am going to save, as I like to do. And let's go to war, shall we? All right. Dun, dun. Oh, it's good music for it, too. Dun, 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 dun. All right. Declare war. Place in the sun. Java. Got 32 war scores. That's going to be pretty substantial. So Switzerland is likely to join Prussia and Austria. Only maybe. There's no guarantee that they're going to hop in this war with us, but let's see what we can do. All right, guys. It is time. So we have no leaders over here. Only have that one leader. Oh, God. Did they already declare war? I don't know. No, I think they just happened to be there. If they happen to join the war, though, that'll be nice. They've already got a giant army over there. Let's go to Antwerp and... Hey, what's going on? All right, buddy. It looks like it's connected there, but apparently they're telling me it's not. Okay, there we go. All right, good deal. Yeah, go there. And you guys... It's all cavalry. All right. Yeah, go there. And go there. All right. Switzerland joined. Austria joined. And Prussia did not join. Damn it. Damn it, Prussia. Okay. All right, I need to slow this down. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. I need to slow this down indeed. Hey buddy, you gonna come help me? Show wars. Nah, I don't know what's going on with my graphics right here. I don't know why those aren't completing across there, but anyhow. Aw, damn it, you know what? Since I called Austria, now they're the fucking war leader. I don't know that I really wanted that. Whoever's the largest nation will assume the role of war leader whenever you start wars. Oh, I forgot about Luxembourg, too. I gotta go kill them. But anyhow, we've got a war going on right here. Pretty big battle. Luckily, they don't have a lot... they do not have a leader either, much like us. So... Yeah, I'm gonna... I don't want them to try to kill me. We'll arrive and I don't. You know what? Stay right. No, I'm incurring. No attrition. I'm gonna stay here until they try to run at me, and then I'll try to get away if I can. All right. I don't like how the war sound effects are so much louder than everything else in the game. I mean, yeah, it's war, but just a little bit of a tedious sound effect. Where are you going? Going to Hasselhoff there? Oh, where are you trying to go now? Antwerp. Antwerpen. Alright. You need to finish up this war so I can fucking do other stuff. Would you please? Alright, clean coal is mine. Let's move on to try to get iron. And... that went okay. Lost just over 300 men. They lost around 1,500, so... we'll take it. They are in full retreat. They're going to head into Eindhoven. And I'm going to chase them. Where are you going? They are both moving. You're going to have 3,000 go to Hasselt. Hasselt, yeah. So there'll be 6,000 there. And then you have another less than 3,000 heading this way. So that's a pretty small army. And you've got around 5,000 heading up here. Those are going to leave on the 13th and 14th, and he will be there on the 14th. So let's see what I can do. What do I want to do? I want to take my cavalry and destroy him. How soon will I get there? On the 13th? When are you going to get to Hasselt? Not on the 13th, but he's going to reinforce him in time. I know he will. You know what? Let's... let's just bum rush him. That'll be good. Anybody gonna send any help? Austria? Maybe? Austria? No? He might not be able to get there due to not having military access. It's kind of hard to swing a ship all the way around. Though he does have ships and plenty of soldiers down here. Send a boat around Spain and France and back around here and land right there. It's doable. Economy's still going pretty well. I could mobilize and get more troops. Not sure that I want to. Not sure that I want the, well, fuck it. I'm at war. I need to do it. Who do I think I am? I mean, when I play larger countries, like if I'm playing the United States, well, I might be able to get away without it due to the large population anyhow. But no, I'm going to go ahead and mobilize. And, ooh, look at all these free troops. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. All right, so now we need to reassess what's going on here. You've got a really beat down army right here, and I'm gonna go ahead and just really press the issue if I can. And yeah, take him out. Surprised the Netherlands is keeping their large doom stack there and not moving it around. It's actually allowing me to get some good leverage in the game so I can pick off his little smaller armies piecemeal. Oh shit, he's on the move, just as I said something. He will be in Rotterdam on the 5th of July, so fairly soon. I'm going to hold tight for now and see what his next move is. This war's about to be over, so I can start sending him back toward the front. Excuse me, I'm waiting till these guys improve a little bit here on their organization before I send them up, if possible. And yeah, just wait till I see if he's making a move or not. And he is now. Okay. So we lost 400 men here, but we killed 1,600, and we got him on the move. What we're going to do is send our cavalry to chase him and send our other troops, hell, how about down here to Luxembourg to fuck them up? So that sounds good to me. And then we'll take our other troops, and, you know, I'd like to sit around and wait longer, but I just don't have time. I don't have time to do that. So he is going to go to Middelburg to try to put a hurting on this guy. And he will be there on the 11th of July. What time can I get out of here? I can get out of here on the 10th. So I can get out of here just in the nick of time before he arrives. And I'll join up with this fucking gangbang here on Antwerp. So he's going to get there on the 10th and initiate the combat. And then he'll be there one day later. And then we're going to have a larger army of 21 units right here in Antwerp, which I can combine with the 15 there in Breda to really fight him mano a mano if I need to, not to mention the fact I have another 12 en route after that. So yeah, this is really going my way. Once I knock out that army, it'll just be a matter of the slow siege of all these provinces to accumulate war score and wait for Austria to force them to go ahead and peace out, which sometimes takes longer than it should, but I seem to be in good position so far. Let's see how fast he moves, if at all. Not very fast. That's his loss. Of course, he's winning there, and he will be in Luxembourg here in a couple of days. Good deal. Good, 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 good. It's all working the plan. I'm going to leave him in Breda if I can, so he doesn't break the siege. Okay, Antwerp. The Battle of Antwerp is over. We lost 500 men. They lost 6,000. Pretty good ratios. I'll take that. I mean, we did have an overwhelming force there at the end. You know, I'm not sure that I want to attack him head on, though. I still would rather him make the first move, to be honest with you. So, I mean, I've got a couple options here. I can either combine up and just kind of hang here and wait and watch, or I can keep these units split up and then go into Dutch territory and start sieging their provinces. But I don't think I'm going to do that. I think I will go ahead and combine them. I wish I could make a general, but I don't have enough leadership to recruit one, so I could lead this army right here. In fact, I wonder if I can, no, I cannot. I can't make that leader leave because he's in foreign territory. Hercules Marley. Hercules Marley. So we're going to wait and see what he's going to do. I'm going to choose the wait and see strategy. Probably not the best one, but we'll see how it works out. Okay, I won over here. Only lost 188 men. They lost nearly 3,000. So that army is finally done with, once and for all. I guess I can leave these guys here to assault. You know what I'd like to do? I'd like to go deeper into their territory to see if they spawn any armies so I can crush them as soon as they pop up. And they are low on organization and morale. Only almost won the Battle of Luxembourg here. And then I can stay there and siege that. So just to have an idea about how this is going to... lost a lot there. More than I'd expect. 500 compared to 1,500. Still winning ratios. Anyhow. If I were to take a look at this war... It is apparently, they say, 3% in my favor. 3%. Okay. Well, we need much more than that. We need to come all the way out here to this little triangle. So we got some work to do yet. Which really, you don't get a ton of war score for the battles themselves. You would think you would for all the people you killed, but not really. It's more so once you actually siege these provinces. And again, that is a long... time-consuming process. But, you know, we'll see what we can do. Let's head over here. Yeah, that Prussian army still sitting around doing jack-all. Whatever. Liberal agitation. Huh. All right. You get a lot of pop-up events like that, which are eventually going to make the game more and more likely to have rebellions as it goes on. So we will get there on the 7th, and he will leave on the 5th. That's good. Because then that means we'll be in Middleburg, and then he'll be in Rotterdam. And actually, then we have him almost in a pincer, if you'll look there. Because what we can do, and actually, let's do this right now. This might be perfect. We're going to split those off, select this unit, send him to Amsterdam. Once he gets to Middleburg, then he will be completely encircled. And once this happens, we're going to take a bit of the forces from all of them, but leave some in place for defense and create a joint strike on Rotterdam and finally end this war. Once and for all, as far as the large fighting goes, it'll just be a matter of sieging the provinces after that. But the cool thing about that is generally in this game, oh shit, he might change my plans all up. What I was going to say is once you have an enemy encircled and they are unable to go anywhere to escape, then they lose all of their troops. They'd lose all 31,000. So anyhow, let's, he will arrive there on the 9th. Wow. This will change things a bit because... You know, you're not going to get there to the 7th. Damn. Well played, Dutch. Well played. So I need to back him up. I mean, there's nothing... No two ways about it. I've got to back him up. Yeah, let's do that. So you'll get there... Ooh, on the 9th? Oh, shit. I need to send him up to Amsterdam then, because he can get there quicker. Because the 9th I might get caught. Alright, well, let's see how this plays out. I might actually get my cavalry stuck up there in Amsterdam. Apologize for the rumble of the microphone there. Alright, gonna go ahead and move this army up into position. They will be there on the 11th, and he's going to be here on the 9th. And one more day, and you're out of Utrecht. Yeah, don't expect me to pronounce any of these Dutch names correctly. I cannot do that. All right, so you can get out of there on the 13th. What time we... Oh, no, he caught me. He fucking caught me. Damn it. This is bad. He's going to wipe out my cavalry. Damn it, I thought I had the one up on him, but he cleverly turned it around on me, flipped the script. Good job to Holland. But hopefully it'll be short-lived. All right, so you're going to try to mess up my guys, so I'm going to try to mess up you. So we're going to have a total of, let's see, it'll end up being, what, 38 versus 31, but 8 of the 38 is going to get pretty badly outnumbered for a day or so. So here is the 12th. That's when they're commencing the attack. And I'm going to be on their 16th. So yeah, they've got to hold out for 4 days. They might actually be entirely routed and defeated by that point. So this is a little hairy. Plus, we're fighting on their territory. You know, need you for, you know, forget that. And they've got actually more cavalry than me. I mean, that's a lot of cavalry, but they've got more of that in their army with all these other infantry units. Actually, look at that. That took 400 of his men there. Oh, and here we go. Now the big war begins. This is the war of the game so far. So you can kind of see all the battles going when you see the numbers pop up. Kind of like an RPG, see who did more damage. It corresponds, of course, to how many men were killed. Yeah, they're doing better than me right now. I'm continually losing more than they are. There we go. They lost a little bit more. Okay, so it looks like we won that. Not as good of a ratio as I normally have. I lost almost 4,000 men. They lost about 4,500, but that's okay. You know, I wish this game would keep track of total losses, you know, total casualties in a war. So you could pull that up when you're looking at the details of the war. You know, you can see when it began, you know, how long it's been going on, and how many casualties have taken place. And if it factored that in to the war exhaustion score, that would be more accurate in my opinion, but... He's gonna arrive in Rotterdam. You know, I should have fucking left a guy behind when I came here, but oh well. Got all these guys here. Oh, you know what? No, I thought they remembered that I wanted them to go to Rotterdam, but I guess not. 24th and 28th. And he's going to be under 28, so I'm going to beat him there. So I'm going to be able to initiate this war as a defensive war, which is gives me a bonus. Plus, when you factor in the fact that there's a river there, I mean, it's going to be like he's crossing a river, essentially. So it'll be like my troops have set up there. And anytime an attacker has to cross a river, he does incur a penalty for that. So let's see. Yeah, both these guys are going to be here on the 28th next day. There we are. So you can see that even though we fought a big war, like most of his army still left, if you're able to successfully encircle them and cut off their path of retreat, then you can actually just wipe out the entire army, and it speeds things up significantly. I wasn't able to do that, though. Because the AI was surprisingly intelligent there, and instead of waiting for me to encircle them, they attacked, which is what you should have done in that situation, to be quite honest with you. They are losing a lot, about 1,000 men a day at this point. It's getting bad. The tide is really turning. The force of my numerical advantage is really adding up. Let's see here. Yeah, he's having the cross, plus I'm dug in. It's getting bad for him. And finally, hey, look at this. No, that's Russia. I thought it was Austria finally showing up. Yeah, they lost 12,000 men in that war. That's pretty bloody. That's a pretty big battle by any standards. We lost 3,500. Yeah, that's our... Pretty bad too, one of our worst days in the war in terms of just losses. Big victory though, big victory. So he's just gonna run back to his capital. Be a little game of ping pong here. What I'm actually gonna do at this point is take my other, well, you know what, I'm split on this though. If I split these guys up though, there we go, and I move him here. That'll be good. That'll be good. So what I'm doing essentially is not only am I going to hold Rotterdam, I'm sending a cavalry brigade over to Utrecht to hold on to that. And so I've cut off this retreat. I've left the enemy stranded on the Amsterdam Peninsula. And I'm also sending one of the cavalry units to the Amsterdam province. Because it's faster than all the other infantry, which is racing there. So what's going to happen is he's going to set up a day early, and that way we'll have the defensive position in this upcoming battle. Not that we need it, but you know, I'll take any help that I can get. And even though we're mobilized, our economy is still doing great. I love it. And yeah, let's see what's going on here. Yeah, it's still only artisans that aren't doing well. Everybody else is doing great, so that's awesome. Oh, military spending, okay. I should probably bump this up, shouldn't I? If I max it out, I still make a great profit, so I'm gonna do that. You know what? No, actually, no, I'm not. I don't know that that's the best. Eh, whatever. Let's do it. Yeah, you're fucked now, buddy. And I finally almost got Breda. And Luxembourg's still gonna take a while, unfortunately. Yeah, this isn't gonna go well for you. Speed this up a little bit since this war is pretty much decided, and yeah, there you go. You see, oh, the Battle of Luxembourg. They spawned a new army, and we smacked them down real quick. When armies first spawn, they don't have a lot of organization or morale, so they're very vulnerable. So if you can hit an army when it first spawns, what? There's a fucking strait there. They can. Oh man, I thought I had them for sure. Yeah, they're crossing over, bastards. I wonder if I can stop that with my navy. When are you gonna be there? On the 30th? When are you gonna be there? 26? I don't think I'm gonna beat him. Well, oh well. Let's run him over. I'll get the cavalry to beat him again by day, and that way we've got the defensive position. If you can have if you can have a navy in the area where the strait is, then land units won't be able to cross. So, that's what I was hoping to do, but I don't know if he's going to get there in time. Oh! I forgot how quick ships are. He's going to be there tomorrow, which is in plenty of time. So it should stop these guys, and then boom, they have to go to war again. Yeah. Yeah, there they go. Now they are... Crushed. Oh shit, but now I shouldn't have even brought my ships out, because they're just clipper transports, and Netherlands actually has a real navy. Look at this ship right here. Yeah, they've got two heavy ships and two light ships, and all I've got is three transports. That's horrible. I can try to retreat if I can. But it matters not, because I have won the land war. Never get in a land war with Belgium, is what they say. Anyhow, gonna begin the long, arduous process of conquering all these lands. Let's move him to Eindhoven. Once he gets to Eindhoven, I'll split him again and move to Maastricht. Split these guys up and send him over to this one that the Prussians are sitting on. That'll be good. Oh, and I've already got this one, so good news. Middleburg will be mine now. Actually, let's split you into two. Send the 9,000 unit to Middleburg and send the other unit up here. So that should be good. I'm going to give myself a quick save point here. Oops, didn't mean to do that. And now I'm going to speed the game up, so I appreciate you sticking with me through that. But now we can speed it up and see what happens. How long this is going to take us. All kind of agitation going around and being removed, actually, as well. Thought it was all my guys there, but it was a large Prussian army. So yeah, let's split these guys up. hour siege in their entire nation. Who just popped in there? Yeah, France. I'm trying to take my shit. Alright, let's go to diplomacy. Nah. Can't do anything with Luxembourg. I was hoping maybe I could outright annex them, but I guess not. Am I at war with Switzerland's on my side? Yeah, I forgot. Could not remember. I mean, do you have anybody in this war with you, sir? Ah, shit, you're at war with France, too. Sucks to be you, Netherlands. Sucks to be you. You're definitely gonna lose that. Okay, so I got some rebels going on here. I'm gonna come up here and try to smash rebels. What kind of rebels are these? Wallonian nationalists. Wildcat bills. A bank run has ensued in one of our states today. Ooh, that's not good. All pops are just capitalists. Just capitalists. That's fine. Oh shit, I beat him from all the way down there. Pretty nice. Wiped him out as soon as he got to Antwerp. Oh no, he still isn't there. Man, you're a slow guy. You rebel. Rebel scum. Let's see. We are much more reactionary, which if you're unaware, that's like super conservative. That's where you want to actually, conservative, you want to maintain the status quo. Reactionary, you actually want to repeal changes and take things back to how they used to be. And of course, liberal wants more changes, so. Progressive. The March on Brussels, bloody revolution. Damn, okay. Oh, I'm starting to get these territories. I didn't even notice that, so that's awesome. You can see they're striped up there. That means they are mine. That is good news, so. Let's send these guys deeper into Belgium territory, because these troops over here are pretty weak. They might not be able to siege so fast. Let me tell you, Austria better initiate some peace. Oh, did they? Okay. I can propose peace now for some reason, even though I'm not the war leader. That's odd. They would not accept this offer. Our war score is not high enough. It's only 18 right now. Okay. Well, what else do I have to do? I guess there's still a few territories to fall. Yet. No need to panic. Was I able to get to back to my base? No, I wasn't. I lost all those ships, didn't I? Damn it. That sucks. Oh well. Wait a second. Is France and England at war? Huh. Yeah, they are. Wow. That's a pretty big war. I mean, that's good for me. These two guys are distracted. Negotiate. Smack some more rebels down. Got some cheap iron. That's good. Conquered Middleburg. And actually, the whole country is almost conquered at this point. That's good. All right, Masaryk, drop. All right, that is the entire country of... Oh, no, you didn't. Oh, fuck. What just happened? Okay, all right, cool. Wow, did they add a war goal on for me? They added Bali? Or did they take that for themselves? Greedy bastards they are. So I've got Java. And where's Dutch Bali? Yeah, they took it for themselves. Assholes, I did all that fighting. That wasn't you. Man, that's a jerky move right there. Take it for yourself. And that one's got gold. Oh no. Oh no. Man, Austria. Anyhow, let's be happy. We got what we came out for. Actually, that was a near-term goal. I got that a lot quicker than I thought I would, to be honest with you. So let's see what we got here with Java. We got a lot of the world's coffee production, that's for sure. And you got these three large provinces all making coffee. Actually, let's just switch over to this mode. Got some fruit, you can do some canned goods with that. Got some sulfur, I'm gonna make some firearm material. A lot of sulfur, actually. That's cool. Let's see here, in fucking Austria, they got the gold province. Jerks. Okay. Well, I can come up here and wage war against these guys, because they've actually got three juicy gold provinces right there, which I would love to have. And that's going to be a priority for me, to get that before they fall off the map. Whew. What is this? Rubber? You usually don't see rubber this early in the game. That's interesting. Hmm. Okay. Trying to see if there's anything else I can notice that was going on. Alright. Well. Yeah, if I can come down here and take all of this, that rubber's pretty important, and then all that gold, that'd be awesome. Of course, I'd also like to take this island at some point. And there's oil. Oil usually doesn't show up this early either. That's weird. Okay. Let's see here. Is there oil over here now as well? Yeah, it sure is. I could take Abu Dhabi at some point and set myself up nicely for the end of the game with a couple of easy oil provinces right there. Let's see who else has oil. Nothing crazy. What about Africa? What are some good places over here? UK already has that, of course. Tropical Woods pretty nice, though. I can always get some of that, and that's actually pretty populous as well. Alright, but you know, this is all long down the line. I don't even have a navy of any sort, seeing as how I lost my entire navy in that war. I don't even feel like I gained that much either. I mean, Java's nice. It's eventually going to help me, but... wish I could have got more out of Netherlands there. But what we're going to do is wait 5 years and do it again. So let's come up here and demobilize. There you go. All right. Oh, they did build another leader there. That's cool. 13 of 18. That's good. All right. So our maximum number there is increased for sure. Let's lower our military spending a bit, shall we? I don't want to overemphasize soldiers and have people not wanting to work in a factory or something because it pays so good to be a soldier. Let's see. And yeah, the only people not getting all of their needs is artisans. There's 58,000 artisans in the game here. Versus... how many craftsmen do I have? 30,000. I could definitely use 119,000 artisans. Wow. I could definitely use less artisans and more craftsmen. Let's take Java out of the equation, though. There's more people in Java than all of the rest of Belgium combined. But so that skews the numbers a bit. So, yeah, there are about 30,000 in Wallonie and... in Vlaanderen, there is 70,000, so about 100,000 total compared to 20 plus 10, 30,000 craftsmen. Could definitely use that ratio shifting a little bit more in the craftsman favor. Oh, look at that! Our fabric factory is actually full up now. That is awesome. So we're going to go ahead and expand that in addition to our canned goods factory. And of course, now we got a cheap source of fruit for our canned good factory, which is always nice. I could have swore. Okay, I think this is the things I need to expand the factory itself, but to actually make these goods, I do indeed need Could have swore I needed fruit for that. You know, the things you actually put in the cans. Let's see here, production. Okay, I was wrong. I guess you don't need fruit to put in the can. You actually need grain, fish, and cattle. Canned meat. Canned meat. 11% of the world's canned food production. Let's see what else do I make. I make a lot of textile, right? Because, yeah, look at that. How much am I in there? 11% of the world's production there. That's decent. Decent. What else do I make? I like to think I'm a decent steel producer. 6% of that. Okay. Oh, coal. Yeah. Yeah. A lot of coal. So that is a first war successfully at a close here for Belgium. We are up to 9th in world power now. All we need to do is jump up one more spot, and we will be sitting pretty. Ooh, look at all this money I'm making now off of Java. Oh, hell yeah. I got a new discovery, pit coal, that can increase my... that was kind of loud, sorry. Increase my already high... coal production even higher, and we do have a small rebellion to worry about right here, but nothing too major. It looks like France is going to end up grabbing Luxembourg, unfortunately. They're at least going to make Netherlands spit them out as an independent nation. Anyhow, let's run down south and take care of these rebels. And let's put these guys in our capital. Okay. That's good. Get them more conscious. I don't mind eventually going a little more liberal. Sounds like a reasonable man. That's a pretty decent army there. 5 brigades of infantry to go along with an artillery and 3 units of cavalry. I need to try to produce some a navy of some form. Make some steam transports would be good. Because I'm eventually going to have to move people around. And this is my only port, so yeah, I need to do that. I don't suppose I can field troops over in Java, can I? I can make ships at least. That'll be nice. Oh, I guess I just inherited a bunch of troops. Huh. I mean, there's still 10,000 Dutch fucks there, but I certainly did inherit a decent army, 24,000. I will take it. Also plan on taking Bali at some point. There's a lot of people there, even though it's, you know, just fish, but I'll take the population for sure. Let's see here, and I guess I can't build any more of an army, but I don't really don't need to, considering I've inherited that large force right there, even though most of it's irregulars, I'll still take it. Let's see if I can't build a ship, though, and also I need to build a naval base somewhere, if I don't already have one. Did the Dutch have a naval base here? It doesn't look like it, unfortunately. Huh, alright. We're gonna make one right there in Batavia. Naval base and make some navy. Make yourself a few transports. I may be ahead of the world on that one with the steam transports. I'm not sure there's any factory set up to actually produce steam transports at the moment, so that could be a waste of time. I'll take a look at it in a second and see how they're gathering their goods for the construction, if at all. Got it in high speed, folks. Trying to zoom along here. Economy is just fucking killing it. Just excellent, excellent economy. Oh, yeah, you want military access, Netherlands? Yeah? Why don't you go bugger off somewhere else and lose another war? Actually, don't. I want you to keep all your land until I can take it from you. How much infamy do I have? Five? Okay. You know what? I really don't want France having military access either, because all that's going to mean is they're going to beat up on the Netherlands, and I don't want them to do that. In fact, England, where are you? Aren't you at war with France? You guys do something. Looks like they're controlling the channel, so France can't send their troops around in ships to the Netherlands. But then again, I'm not going to give them a military access, so they can't pass through my sovereign state as well, so they're kind of stuck there. Unless they can get Prussia to let them around, which I hope they don't. Alright, got another something. Let's see. Good culture. Alright. Integral distillery process. It's nice. Let's see what's going on around the world. Oh, look at this. The USA has already quickly colonized the Pacific Northwest. They just have southern Idaho to go there. Of course, Russia still owns Alaska at this point. France still wants military access. You know what? You didn't want to give me an alliance at the beginning of the game, so go screw yourself. I hope you get in a war with Prussia. More liberal. I'll take it. Hey, how did these guys get around? Fucking Prussia let them around. Bastards. Why'd you do that, Prussia? Slightly more liberal. Small arms production increased. Let's see. Yeah, stop asking. Ooh. I've already got steam transports. That's awesome. Let's see. Did I already produce some down here as well? I did. Okay. Yeah, I really need to start seriously considering going to war with these guys. Let me try to produce a war justification to establish protectorate. That is a cheaper way to go to war, infamy-wise, against uncivilized nations, you know, at least the way the game considers them. These minor powers, which aren't Christian, Western, Eurocentric-based, and they consider uncivilized. Yeah, a little bit of bias showing there from the developers, but that's okay. I mean, it's kind of how the world was at the time, at least from the Western point of view. So let's see here. If detected, a maximum of 10 infamy. So right now I'm sitting at 5. That'll take me to 15. There's a maximum of 25 before you really get into those containment wars. So, yeah, I can deal with it. Who knows? I mean, hopefully I won't even be discovered. That would be nice. Oh, and I got troops up here, too. I didn't even notice them. That's cool. Yeah. And this is Dutch territory. I need to get them out of there. Send these transports up there to get them out. Perhaps build some more transports as well. I mean, I got basically all the money I could want at this point, so it doesn't really matter. Oh, France, just give it up. No means no. Fuck, they discovered our plan, so we did get the infamy on that, but, Damn it. Alright, so we're losing speed on that CB generation, but, oh well. We gotta go for a prestige gain, invention, so hopefully improve our world ranking here at some point. Hendrick Conscious Publishers. Flemish language novelist. Of course, Flemish culture, Flanders, as it was historically known, is part of Belgium at this point. So this does concern me. Hail the Lion, the Flemish Lion. He was known to produce That gives us some prestige, which is nice. Got some factories being built, it sounds like. The nation of Switzerland is calling me to war against Sardinia Piedmont, who, you know, people might not know of that nation today. Kind of got gobbled up by Italy. But they are a decent power in the game at this point. 13th in the nation, actually, in the world. So, let's see, who is in this battle? And it looks like a one-on-one affair. And they want to conquer Savoy, which is this upper region of Piedmont. Yeah, just really that one. These two. Well, they are my ally, and they did come to war with me against the Netherlands, so I suppose I should. Let's see who they are. Yeah, they're not allied with anybody. Yeah, fuck them. Let's do it. Whatever. I mean, I don't even really have to send anybody, to be honest with you. I can just be, air quotes, in the war, providing my support. Shit. Actually, fuck Switzerland. You might have got into some shit. They've got 33 against, what's that, 23 plus 8, 31. Yeah, you got less troops, buddy. Has anybody else joined this war? Nope. Yeah, I guess I need to send somebody. I can load some people onto these ships and send them around. Perhaps even, am I the war leader in this war? Yeah, I am. Okay. So, theoretically, I could add a war goal on here. And maybe snatch a Mediterranean port, a rich one like Genoa, historically profitable trade city. Maybe. Actually, it would be even nicer. Would be to snatch this island where I can get some sulfur and gold. Yeah, let me take Sardinia. That would be beautiful. Wonder how much war score that would require. Anyhow, we have something to occupy our time now. Another war, yay! Let's build some steam transports. That would be fun. Of course, they'll be completely undefended, so... Yikes. Better hope we don't get attacked. Let's see, what are we doing? We are exporting sulfur as one of our top exported items, so if we get more from Sardinia, that's only going to improve that industry. Things we could use to improve upon would be liquor, tea, and furniture. I don't see tea really happening anytime soon. Well, there was that one Dutch province that we could eventually take. I think it had a little bit of tea. A little bit of tea. Yeah, right there. Actually, that's an independent. We could take them out anytime. We don't need to go to war with the Dutch again. That's pretty damn profitable, actually. We're going to take these guys out, in fact. We're going to get some coffee, improve our monopoly on coffee with Java. Add some tea, add some tobacco. Yeah, a little bit of grain, let's say. But if we can create a little bit of a unity here, because we're going to take out Johor. And we can add Adja along with it. So if we could take those two provinces, that'd be nice. And then, of course, Bali eventually. And long-term, the rest of this. So we have a nice Indonesian base of operations down here. Okay. Let's get back into this. And keep this game going high speed, chugging along. Okay, we have got our war justification against Johor now, which is good. So we can go to war with them. Got some people on the boat here. We can't carry any more weight. I wonder what kind of army they have. Let's take a look into that, will we? Military score of 3. What does it take to get a military score of 3, I wonder? Let's see if it'll tell me in here. I think there's something on here that'll tell me how many brigades they have. Yeah, so let's go to Johor. I got 3 brigades. That's what I have right now. I would like to add more along with that, so. Yeah, let's move these guys over here so we can add more onto the ship. And maybe change out some of those irregulars on the ship currently for more of the standard troops here so they can, our standard infantry, so they can fare better in the war, in the war. All right. How's these ships coming? Can we get any, of our capitalists doing anything? Are they building any factories or anything nice like that? Doesn't look like it. Doesn't look like anything has to be expanded just yet. What about railroads? Yeah, we are maxed out on our infrastructure here in Belgium. That's nice, at least. Excuse me. Oh, France. Give it up. Have you made war, peace with England yet? No, you haven't. Nor with Netherlands. And I don't... Okay, there you are. Yeah, you're still in the Netherlands. Okay. Alright, so we're actually in 8th place now, but we're not officially considered a great power, which the top 8 are the great powers of the world, and they can colonize and have other special benefits, like placing nations into their sphere of influence. We're not going to actually leap into that officially until we hold this 8th position, or better, for a period of 6 months. So, Spain, you are on the chopping block, buddy. If you don't get your shit together quick, we are coming for your lunch. So let's go in and accept that. Now, as soon as we're great power, I've got some decisions to make. I either want to try to put Hanover under my sphere of influence, under my thumb, as it were. So we'll at least be ready to do that when they get when they break away from the UK in terms of being a satellite upon the coronation of Victoria, which will happen here soon. Either go for them to try to block Prussia a little bit, or I can try to pick up Spain, because Spain will suddenly become a secondary power instead of a great power, and they would be a pretty nice one to pick up if I can, though I will be in tough competition. I mean, I'm sure France is going to be going for them, and England, and yeah, so they're going to be tough, but they would be a nice one if I could pick them up. We'll think about it. A lot of options in this game. But anyhow, we'll lose our sphere status with the UK, so hopefully the Netherlands will be dumb enough to attack us at some point. Let's see what we have here. All right, so we got all these guys. Let's merge them together, and then let's dump the infantry off. Suck them. Can you load onto the boat? Do we have an admiral? We don't. Okay, can we make an admiral? No. Let's stop auto-creating leaders, because I feel like I need an admiral, and you guys aren't making one. But you know what I do, what I can do, is take the leader away from this army. Okay. And add him to this army. There we go. And they can load 2 more. So let's do that. There we go. All right. Got a decent sized army here. And let's head them up here to Johor. Johor Bahru. And see what kind of trouble we can get into. One day, Netherlands, one day. Looks like a Mott and Yahoo song. rebel swine. Alright. I need to flip and help these guys out with their war down here. They're probably getting beat up pretty badly. Actually, no, they're conquering some, they do have most of the territory that they want, Savoy. They're working on the last bit of it now. Expanded a little bit into northern Piedmont. However, they're getting smashed by this doomstack of Sardinia. So hopefully their unit of, their stack of 12 here won't do anything stupid. Hopefully it'll just stay here and defend and try to recapture their one territory that Sardinia was able to take from them and be positioned nicely in the mountains there for defense. They're about to lose their capital up here. Hopefully that won't make them surrender. But if I can get over here and attack that stack there outside of the mountains, that would be great. That would be perfect. And ideally even have one of these two guys help me out. We can hope. Which, like I said, he's going for him. Oh, that, so much for all that thinking. Hopefully he get hurt pretty bad. Oh yeah, look how fast he dropped because he's fighting in the mountains. Oh my god. That was a fucking mistake, Sardinia. Jesus Christ. Huh. Well, we beat the rebels pretty bad. I mean, they might end up fighting this out to a draw, but at what cost? I mean, you know, they outnumbered the Swiss 2-1 there. Anyhow, let's load these guys on the boat. Boom. Got most of them on there. No. What? That's nonsense. I want to have my leader leading the army. I'm going to send out, obviously. Fuck. I have to sit him off of the boat. And add him. Okay. And load him back up. There we go. Alright, let's send this army out. Over to... Am I just going to take Sardinia? Oh no, I should probably help him if he needs it. Yeah, I mean, yeah, the Swiss won that battle. Jesus. This war turned quickly. Now it's about even, I'd say. 7-7 versus 6-4. Slightly in the Swiss's favor, but you never know with the AI what they're going to do. Oh shit, my ships are fast. Man, that's fast. Yeah, I guess come up here and smash this army, and then we can come down and worry about Sardinia, I suppose. Okay. Got an army of 18,000 there. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. Can I beat him? Can I beat him? Can I beat him? I didn't beat him. Damn it. Da, 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 da. I really don't want to attack him in the mountains, to be honest with you. But I don't want to sit here all day either. Turin. Maybe think of Dave Turin from that gold show. I don't know if you guys watch that, but the kind of crap I get addicted to. All right, let's see here. How did this turn out? Okay, so they've got an army of 9 now. Are we at war with you yet? If not, we're about to be. Boom. War. Annex. Done. So now we're involved in 2 wars. We're quite the... every year of our existence, we've been in a war, basically. Quite the warmongering little people. We little people of Belgium. Oh, the wee little people. Oh, they're so cute. Oh, so cute, so cute. Yeah, I don't think they're going to move. And in fact, I mean, you guys got them beat now, so... Let's come back out here onto these ships and... go take Sardinia. Because that would be cool. damn, fucking crushed Johor. They had 9,000 people and they all died. That's pretty beastly. Nice, they're going to take back over their capital. That'll be good for the war score. They've got all of Savoy at this point. Once they take that capital back over, they might be able to get what they came for in this war, but I'm not really concerned with what they came for. I'm concerned with what I want and what I can get my greedy little paws all over, and that is Sardinia. Schmarpinia. Snar, 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 snar. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. We're taking a little Johor. Let them express their opinions. Peace and love. Happy, happy.